Here are 5 reasons Windows 11 is worth the upgrade. What new features make it a viable operating system for people to use? Well, we're about to find out. Starting off with number 1, we have completely revamped visuals and sounds. With every new version of Windows comes a new user interface that gives the OS new character, and Windows 11 is no different. It introduces the presence of new blur effects like Mica and acrylic that improve upon the blurs that were present in previous versions of Windows. There are now new animations throughout the OS that make using Windows feel more fluid and dynamic. Many system icons have been redesigned to stay up to date with the modern design language, even icons from very old applications like the control panel. Of course, one of the biggest highlights is the presence of rounded corners everywhere throughout the operating system, though it's not like we haven't seen this in previous versions of Windows, but still a nice throwback. And if you're into dark mode, you'll definitely like Windows 11 in this aspect. Although only a few more apps have been updated to work with dark mode, at least so far, because of how the new blurs and icons were designed, it makes the dark mode experience feel more vibrant and exciting than it was in Windows 10, where the only thing they really did was make everything black, and it sort of made various other elements and icons look awkward or out of place. Finally, to complement the new visuals, Microsoft has updated the system sounds to have a calmer and more soothing tone, and you'll even hear them with an echo effect if you're using dark mode, making the experience feel even more immersive. There's still a lot to discover in terms of looks and style, but these are just some of the highlights. Number 2, we have better UI consistency. Well, what does this mean? To give context, one of the biggest problems with Windows 10 was how various applications and system elements had inconsistent UIs. There were times when you found decently modern elements throughout Windows 10, but then there were times when you could see some very old stuff. But what was really jarring was how you'd find multiple versions of the same application. Windows 11, although not perfect, does a really good job minimizing this issue. You'll notice that many applications and elements such as MS Paint, Notepad, and the snipping tool have been updated to better align with the modern design of Windows 11. You'll also notice that numerous duplicate applications have also been removed. Like guys, Internet Explorer was removed from Windows 11, like that's a big deal. Elements that are so essential, like the right-click context menus, have been updated with a new design to stay consistent as well. And if that wasn't enough, visuals to already modern apps, such as Mail, Calendar, and Calculator, have been updated with rounded corners and blur effects to stay consistent. The little details. Once again, nothing is perfect. There will be times when you come across an ancient application in Windows 11, and you'll be like, but compared to the state that Windows 10 was in, this is a significant improvement. Moving on to number 3, Windows 11 has made Windows more simple and less cluttered. If you look back on Windows 10, there were various instances where things looked a lot more complicated than they really had to be. For example, here's the task viewer in Windows 10. Microsoft tried to make this an all-in-one deal, where you have a timeline of your previous programs and files, and all your current programs that are open in the background, and all your virtual desktops that are open in the background. But really, this all-in-one approach makes everything look super complicated and cluttered for really no reason, and it probably puts some users off. Windows 11 fixes this by just showing what is currently open and simplifies the overall UI to make it user-friendly, and it moves the timeline of your files and programs to the Start menu. Speaking of the Start menu, this has also been simplified with more organized categories, and it gets straight to the point by removing some of the flashy stuff like live tiles. And here's one of my personal favorites, a much-needed ribbon UI redesign in the File Explorer. When I used to have Windows 10, I basically never touched this thing. It was confusing, cluttered, and because of how poorly designed this thing was, it served more as a distraction for my workflow. Now the ribbon UI has become less cluttered and it's easier to navigate. It's such a clean experience that I started to occasionally use it myself. I just gave 3 examples, but if you do enough exploring, you'll find other parts of the Windows UI that feel much more simplistic, and in a world where access to technology continues to increase, having an intuitive UI is definitely essential. Number 4, touch and tablet refinements. The tablet UI in Windows has had a rough ride. Windows 8 had a very intuitive touch interface, but the touch aspect was so dominating that those without tablet input suffered Windows 8's biggest problem, the confusing user interface. It just made no sense to use Windows 8 if you didn't have a touchscreen. Windows 10 did make navigation easier, but the optimization for touch users was mediocre at best. I'm not even going to talk about the tablet mode in Windows 10, that's its own mess. Windows 11 tries to clean this up. To start, it removes the tablet mode in Windows 10, which honestly was for the best, and focuses on optimizing the desktop for touch. To highlight a few features, moving and resizing windows is now easier with stickier touch inputs, there are new 3 and 4 finger gestures for managing windows and virtual desktops, and there's an updated touch keyboard with more buttons and customization. Instead of creating a completely new user interface for touch users, Microsoft decided to add on to what was already working and found a better balance between touch and desktop. Finally, we've got number 5, multitasking upgrades. Windows 11 has made a few updates and multitasking that might warrant the upgrade for some users. Some of these include Snap Assist templates when hovering over the Maximize button, being able to preview groups of windows open in the background when hovering over taskbar icons, being assisted in finding other windows when snapping into a quadrant instead of, you know, doing nothing, and even things as small as being able to set a different wallpaper for virtual desktops are a nice to have for heavy workload users. Small enhancements, yes, but these little features do improve the user experience in the long run. So, maybe this video gave you a reason to consider Windows 11. Like, subscribe, and thanks for watching.